morning. We are going to talk about the no-poo method today. Please don't mind my appearance, or do. I've been working on my plants. And we are in the balcony because I don't like to work on my hair indoors because I do not want to see any hair flying around inside the house. The idea is to do whatever needs to be done here, collect the hair, and then go back inside. So, if you want to start your transition to no-poo, no-poo is no shampoo. No shampoo, no conditioner. In my case, it is absolutely nothing that comes out of a bottle or a sachet. So, even to start with something like a no-poo, you have to go through a transition. You have to basically go through a clarifying process. उसके लिए आपको यू विल हैव टू डू वन वॉश ऑफ योर हेयर विथ ए क्लैरिफाइंग शैम्पू. अ क्लैरिफाइंग शैम्पू इज समथिंग दैट हैज नो सल्फेट्स एंड इट हैज नो डाइमेथिकोन्स सिलिकोन्स. सो गो एंड चेक योर प्रोडक्ट्स एंड देखो उसमें क्या उसके इंग्रीडियंट्स में पीछे कहीं पे कोन्स लिखा है. अगर है दैट मीन्स यू हैव शैम्पूज एंड कंडीशनर्स विद डाइमेथिकोन्स एंड सिलिकोन्स. The problem with these, sorry, I'm distracted by an eagle, which is a rare sight. So the problem with dimethicones, silicones and sulfates is that they leave a lot of product buildup in your scalp. And in the long run, it's not good for us. Unfortunately, there's little to no evidence that we have of in the long run because not enough generations have been using shampoos and conditioners. So we don't know enough. We don't have enough information. Now, what I'm doing, I started no-poo back in 2019 in October, and I did not even have to go through a transition because uske pehle se I had been washing my hair with Shikakai Amla Richa. I don't recommend doing that. I'm not going to recommend any of that right now. I'm just going to tell you how to go about the transition. So, you can use a clarifying shampoo if you want, if you've been using dimethicones, silicones and sulfates. Once you've done that, you have to then get used to the idea of not doing anything at all. You're not going to be washing with shampoos, you're not going to be conditioning, you're not going to do anything except cold water. And that too will not be done every day. So right now what I'm doing is a process called scritching and preening. Scritching and preening ka matlab hai ki aapne aise aise karke, you run your fingers through your hair. This is what you do. So you are activating all the sebum, the oil in your scalp. And preening is to run it all the way from the root to the tip of your hair. One of the reasons that I prefer my hair short is because this process is so easy. And so this also enables better circulation in the scalp. Do it about 5-7 minutes. And there is also something called a boar bristle brush. B-O-A-R, boar. Bristle brush, which can be used for stretching and preening. But because my hair is so short and it is quite scant, although thanks to no-poo, I've had very good hair growth and not a lot of hair fall, so I can't complain. So this helps with the stretching and the preening. The other thing that I also like to do, maybe once in 2-3 days, is use a comb. So once I've done the stretching and preening with my fingers, I use a comb, and I use a wide tooth comb because curly hair, and I just run it through the hair. You are not required to use a comb. You are not even required to use a boar bristle brush. You use whatever works for you. But because I don't have a lot of hair fall, so I don't mind using a comb. So once I've done it in this direction, I've made sure that all the oils that are naturally secreted in my scalp have been redistributed through the length of my hair. Then I'm going to basically flip my head over and do the ulta. Now the other thing that I also do is I cut my own hair. And I cut my hair every, I would say probably 8 to 10 weeks. So it's coming up on the 10 week mark right now. It's been 2 months. Actually, it's probably been a little over 2 months since I cut my hair. So why I also do that is, I do not want my hair to feel weighed down. So as it gets longer, and as the oil production happens, the hair tends to sit flat. And when it does, it feels weighted. So that is one of the reasons that a lot of people experience hair fall also. The other reason is when you tend to tie your hair up all the time. when you do that, वो बेचारे follicles बोलते हैं यार हम नहीं रख सकते इसको, I can't hold on to your hair much longer if this is the intent of your life. So anyway, because I have such a broad runway like matha, forehead, so I anyway like to keep my hair open, and I always like to have a little bit of hair covering it. Of course, I love what I have a very Diana Ross kind of thing going on. Diana Ross meets a monster kind of thing going on. But anyway, so this is the idea of stretching and preening. Stretching and preening has to be done once in 2-3 days, so that you make sure that the oils are redistributed evenly throughout the hair. Stretching and preening also has to be done in the shower, when you're taking a bath, when you're washing your hair. So when you're washing your hair, you're only using water, you're using cold water. Now anybody who lives in a really cold place, jahan pe snow hoti hai, there you can use possibly warm water. But I'm talking about India. India mein kahin, except for possibly the north, kahin pe snow ho nahi rahi hai as such. So when you take a bath, just make sure that you run water through your hair, and when you're doing that, have a white tooth comb in the shower also, and just run it through your hair with water. So again, you are redistributing the oils, and they are now being sealed with water in your hair, in your scalp. Benefits of doing this are that you will never need to oil your hair with an external agent, coconut oil, olive oil, etc., etc., because most people don't know the porosity of their hair, so they would end up possibly using the wrong type of hair in wrong type of oil in their scalp. And there's no need, there's absolutely no need. I have not oiled my hair since October 2019. I don't miss it, and I don't require it, because my hair gets naturally oily, and when it does, I do the stretching and preening, then I wash it in the bathroom. Another thing that you need to do when you're going through this process, oh yeah, every time you stretch and preen and use a comb, you have to wash your comb clean. Use a shampoo, use a soap, use whatever, but it has to be clean. Keep a spare clean toothbrush to clean the comb with. There has to be absolutely no compromise on hygiene here through this whole process. The other thing that I like to do also is apple cider vinegar rinse. I do that maybe once in 2 weeks. एक मग्गा पानी में, once I've done the whole shower and everything, एक मग्गा पानी में I add about 1 cupful of apple cider vinegar, add it to the water, and just run it through my hair and make sure that I again sort of stretch and preen, so that that apple cider vinegar has reached the entire scalp. And after that, you can wash it off, leave it on for about 3 to 5 minutes, and you can wash it off with cold water. So again, it's just to maintain the pH neutrality, the pH balance of your scalp. So as far as no poo and stretch and preen is concerned, this is all you need to do. It is very simple, and your hair, it depends on person to person. Your hair takes anywhere from, sorry, my throat is stretchy. Your hair takes anywhere from 8 to 9 weeks, or maybe for some people even 3 weeks, to a few months. So you have to be patient. अच्छा, stretching and preening. अभी हमने ऐसे stretch and preen किया. So what will happen is the dead skin cells in my scalp, along with the oils, will come to the surface. What I also like to do is, for me that is a very good, that is the sign of a good healthy scalp. So what I like to do is, I basically run my fingers through my hair and do this. जितना भी dry scalp, dead skin cells बाहर निकल सकते हैं, वो सब बाहर निकल आएंगे. And if I have done my stretching and preening right, and then when I go and shower and wash my hair and come back, to know that I have done everything correctly and I have actually done a cleansing of my hair the way I desired to do it. In that case, after I have showered, if I run my finger through a spot, no dead skin cells should be coming out anymore. So, but this will all take some time. Now my hair doesn't smell. I mean, it's been such a long time that I've been doing this, that I am not I'm not worried about any smells, because my scalp does not smell anymore, does not feel dirty. Another thing that I do personally, which is not recommended anywhere, but because I like to do it, is washing my scalp and the rest of the body with besan and dahi. So besan is, I think, chickpea flour. So I use besan and I mix it up with dahi and a little bit of water. And I rub it through my scalp, not intensely, because you do not want to cause any breakage. You just basically lace it through your hair all over and chin. And I also use it for the rest of my body. So clearly my soap usage has also gone down significantly. And then wash it off. You can also leave it in your hair if you like to use it as a mask, because Dahi is excellent as a mask. So you can leave it in your hair for about an hour, 30-35 minutes, and then wash it off cold water. And then again, your scalp feels squeaky clean. So this can be done anywhere from weekly to every 10 days, depending on how frequently you want to do it. I've gone a few months not doing anything except water, apple cider vinegar, stretching and peeling. I hope this helps. Let me know how it goes. And if it doesn't go well, you have to be patient, because the factors that are involved here are stress, sleep, quality of sleep, nutrition, how much you sweat, and hormones. So they all collectively come in and play a very important role in how your hair reacts. But no poo has worked out for practically everybody that I know of, unless you have a skin condition, an underlying dermatological condition like psoriasis or eczema. And because I am not medically or scientifically at all geared in this, so I wouldn't know how it affects each individual individually. But I would sincerely recommend it, because I've had success with it, basically. So, all the best.